So I've been practicing this song to play for you guys, and I haven't played it in a long time. But it's kind of a story song. It's a road trip, family road trip classic song. And it's called The Biggest Ball of Twine in Minnesota. You guys may have heard of it, but you'll catch on to the chorus, and if anyone wants to sing along during the chorus, you guys are welcome to. Okay. Well, I had 2 weeks of vacation time coming after working all year down at Big Roy's Heating and Plumbing. Till one night when my family and I were gathered round the dinner table, I said, kids, if you could go anywhere in this great big world now, where'd you like to go to? They said, Dad, we want to see the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. They picked the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. So the very next day we loaded up the car with potato skins and pickled wieners, Spider-Man comics, crossword puzzles, and Mama's homemade rhubarb pie. Pulled out of the driveway and the neighbors, they all waved goodbye. So began our 3-day journey. Picked up a guy holding a sign that said Twine Ball or Bust. He smelled real bad and he said his name was Bernie. Well, I put on a live Phish CD, my wife put on a brand new hairnet. Kids were in the back seat jumping up and down yelling,
are we there yet?
And all of us were joined together. See the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. We're headed for the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Well, we couldn't wait to get there, so we drove straight through for 3 whole days and nights. Of course, we stopped for more pickled wieners now and then. The scenery was just so pretty. Kids could have seen it, cause you can't see out of the side of the car, cause the windows are completely covered with the decals from all the places where we've already been. Like Elvis Aramo, the Tupperware Museum, the Bow Weevil Monument, the Cranberry World, the Shuffleboard Hall of Fame, Poodle Dog Rock, and the Mecca of Albino Squirrels. We've been to ghost town theme parks, wax museums, and the place where you can drive through the middle of the trees, alligator farms and tarantula ranches. But there's still one thing we gotta see. Well, we crossed the state line about 6:39, and we saw the sign that said Twine Ball Exit 50 miles. Well, the kids were so happy they started singing 99 bottles of beer on the wall for the 27th time that day. So we pulled off the road at the last chance gas station, bought a few more pickled wieners and a diet chocolate soda. On our way to see the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. We're headed to the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Finally, at 7:37 early Wednesday evening, as the sun was setting in the Minnesota sky, out in the distance on the horizon, it appeared to me like a vision before my unbelieving eyes. So we parked the car and walked with awe-filled reverence towards that glorious, huge, majestic sphere. I was just so overwhelmed by its sheer immensity, I had to pop myself a beer. Yes, on these hallowed grounds, open 10 to 8 on weekdays, in a little shrine under a makeshift pagoda, this is the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. It's the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. Oh, what on earth would make a man decide to do that kind of thing? Woe is he trying to prove? beside it, and I warned the kids, now you better not touch it, those ropes are there for a reason. I said, maybe if you're good, I'll tie it to the back of our car, and we could take it home, but I was only teasing. So we went to the gift shop and stood in line, bought a souvenir miniature ball of twine, some window decals, anything else they'd sell us. Couple postcards reading from the twine ball, wish you were here, won't the folks back home be jealous. I gave our camera to Bernie and we stood by the ball and we all gathered round and said cheese. Then Bernie ran away with my brand new Instamatic, but at least we got our memories. So we all just stared at the ball for a while, then my eyes got moist and I said with a smile, kids, this here's what America's all about. And then I started feeling kind of gooey inside, and I fell on my knees and I cried and cried, and that's when those security guards threw us out. You know, I bet if we'd unravel that sucker, it'd roll all the way down to Fargo, North Dakota. 'Cause it's the biggest ball of twine in Minnesota. I tell you, it's the biggest ball. That night at the Twine Ball Inn, in the morning we was on our way home again, but we didn't really want to be, that was perfectly clear. I said, folks, I can tell you're all sad to go, and then